गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट वॉक एंड देयर क्लासिफिकेशंस इन दैट व्हाट इज वॉक एंड ओपन वॉक, क्लोज्ड वॉक, ट्रायल, सर्क्यूट, पाथ एंड साइकिल। वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वॉक एंड देयर क्लासिफिकेशंस इन लास्ट क्लास। इन टुडे क्लास we are going to discuss about Hamiltonian graph. So we see here that how can we find whether a given graph is Hamiltonian or not. Okay, so in a connected graph, a closed walk that contains every vertex of a graph exactly once except starting vertex and ending vertex. So it is called a Hamiltonian cycle. If a graph contains a Hamiltonian cycle, then it is called a Hamiltonian graph. Okay, so in a connected graph, a closed walk. Closed walk means what is that? A sequence with begin and ends with same vertex is called a closed walk. So in a connected graph, a closed walk that contains every vertex of a graph exactly once except starting vertex and ending vertex, it is called a Hamiltonian cycle. If a graph contains a Hamiltonian cycle, then it is called a Hamiltonian graph. So let us consider a graph with vertices v2, v3 and v5 and edges e2, e5, e3. In this graph, we consider a sequence, a cycle V2 to V3, V3 to V5 and V5 to V2. So the graph of the given, the cycle of the given graph is V2 to V3, V3 to V5, V5 to V2. In this sequence, starting and end vertex are same and remaining vertexes are exactly appears only once. So this is called Hamiltonian cycle. So in that sequence, no vertex is repeated except the starting and ending vertices, so that the given graph is a Hamiltonian graph. So a graph contains a Hamiltonian cycle, that graph is called Hamiltonian graph. So what is Hamiltonian cycle means? Except starting and end vertex, remaining vertices are appears only once. That cycle is called Hamiltonian cycle. If a graph contains that Hamiltonian cycle, that graph is called Hamiltonian graph. So let us see second example. So in this graph, it has 5 vertices A, B, C, D, E. We consider cycle for this graph. The cycle is A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, again E to C, C to A. If the cycle starts and ends with A, in that C vertex is repeated twice. So the graph is not contains Hamiltonian cycle. So this graph is not Hamiltonian graph because here C vertex is repeated twice. Okay, so next definition, Euler circuit or Euler cycle. So a closed walk. Closed walk means starting and end vertex is same. So a closed walk which visits every edge of the graph exactly once. A closed walk which visits every edge of the graph exactly once means in a closed walk, no edge repetition is called Euler circuit or Euler cycle. Okay. In a closed walk, no, a closed walk with no edge repetition is called Euler circuit. If a graph contains Euler circuit or cycle, that graph is called Euler's graph. A connected graph G which contains Euler circuit or cycle, Euler cycle, is called Euler graph. So what is Euler circuit? A closed walk with no repetition of edges is called Euler circuit. Okay, the graph contains Euler circuit is called Euler's graph. Open Euler walk. So open Euler walk means a open walk which visits every edge of the graph exactly once. So what is open walk? So starting and end vertices of the walk is different. That walk is called open walk. So a open walk which visits every edge of the graph exactly once is called open Euler walk. So semi Euler graph. So what is semi Euler graph? A connected graph that contains a open Euler walk is called semi Euler graph. So in this, open walk means a walk has starting and end vertices are different, and Euler means no edge repetition with open walk, that is called semi Euler graph. A connected graph it that contains a open Euler walk is called a semi Euler graph. So what is Euler circuit? A closed walk without edge repetition is called closed circuit or Euler circuit or Euler walk, Euler cycle. A graph has Euler circuit, that graph is called Euler's graph. Okay, so open Euler walk means a open walk which visits every edge of the graph exactly once is called open Euler walk. And semi Euler walk graph means a connected graph that contains open Euler walk is called semi Euler graph. Okay, let us consider the examples. So consider the below graphs. Check whether the graph is Euler graph or not. So first given graph representation has the vertices A, B, C, D, E, F, E1, E2, E3, so E4, E5, E6, E7, E8, E9, E10. So the sequence, we consider first Euler cycle. So what is Euler cycle? A2, E1, B, E2, C, E3, D, E4, B, E5, E, E8, F, E9, A, E10, E, E7, D, E6 to A. This is vertices are repeated, edges are visited exactly once. So you observe the sequence, the edges E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E8, E9, E10, E7, E6. So edges are here appears exactly once, but here the vertices are repeated. So this is a closed walk. Okay, vertices are repeated and edges are visited only once. So in the above sequence, it is a closed walk. Closed walk means starting and the end vertices is same. Okay, starting and end vertex is same. So closed walk, because starting vertex and end vertexes be the same and hence the above sequence is Euler circuit or cycle. Then the graph G is called Euler graph. Then the graph G is called Euler graph. Okay. So in this graph, first this is a closed walk, and here the edges are visited only once. So it has Euler circuit. So this graph is Euler graph. Okay. So next another example. So another example. This the graph representation is. So A, B, C, D, E, F, and 6 vertices with edges E, 8 edges. So we consider the sequence. Consider the sequence. So we start the cycle at D. D, E4, A, E1, B, E5, E, E8, E3, C, E2, B, E6, F, E7, D. So in this sequence, starting and ending vertices are same. So this is closed walk and no edge repetition. Only all the edges of the given graph visited only once in this sequence. Okay. So E4, E1, E5, E8, E3, E2, E6, E7. So the given graph is Euler graph because it contains a Euler circuit. When Euler circuit exists in the given graph G, if and only if it contains a closed walk. So edges are visited exactly once. So vertices may be repeated. So the given graph is Euler graph. Okay. So another example, the given graph with 6 vertices and 7 edges. So first of all, we consider the sequence. So now we check it has this Euler circuit or not. So we start at F. So F, E5, E, E4, D, E3, C, E2, B, E1, A, E6, F, E7, C. So this is not a Euler graph. So starting and ending vertex are not same. This is open walk, not closed walk. Okay. So the given graph G is not a Euler graph because it doesn't have contain Euler circuit. The above sequence is an open walk. Hence, we can say that the given graph G is so open walk with without any edge repetition is called what is that? Semi Euler graph. So the given graph is semi Euler graph. Okay. So Dirac's theorem. If G is a simple graph with n vertices, statement, if G is a simple graph with n vertices, n greater than or equal to 3, such that every vertex degree is at least n by 2 in graph G. So then the graph G has a Hamiltonian cycle where n is the number of vertices in G. So what is the statement for Dirac's theorem? If G is a simple graph with n vertices greater than or equal to 3, it means at least the simple graph has 3 vertices such that every vertex degree is at least n by 2, means the degree of each vertex in the simple graph is at least n by 2, means n is the number of vertices in a given graph. So the degree is satisfies the condition n by 2 in a given graph, then the graph G is a Hamiltonian cycle. So we have to show that the given graph has a Hamiltonian cycle where n is the number of vertices in G. Okay. So for example, this is the statement for Dirac's theorem. We now check this statement on considering the example. if we take the graph with four vertices, so the four vertices satisfies the condition n greater than or equal to 3. Okay, so A, B, C, D, this is the given simple graph. Okay, so number of vertices V is equal to 4. Degree of each vertex satisfies n by 2 conditions. So 4 by 2, that is 2. So the degree of each vertex has 2. It satisfies the condition n by 2. Then we have to show that this graph has a Hamiltonian cycle. Okay. So the given graph G contains 4 vertices A, B, C, D. Degree of A is equal to 2. How can we say the degree? The edges incident at the vertex is called the degree of 2. So here 2 edges are incident at A. So the degree of A is 2. Similarly, degree of B is equal to 2 and degree of C is equal to 2 and degree of D is equal to 2. According to Dirac's theorem, so every vertex degree is n by 2. So every vertex degree, so total vertices is 4. So every vertex of the given graph satisfies the condition n by 2. Okay. So that is 4 by 2 is equal to 2. So the given condition is satisfied in the above graph G. Hence, we can say that the given graph has Hamiltonian cycle. That cycle is A, B, C, D, A. A, B, C, D, A. So in that sequence, no vertex is repeated except the starting and ending vertex. So the given graph has Hamiltonian cycle. So the sequence is a Hamiltonian circuit. Hence the given graph G is a Hamiltonian graph. Okay, Hamiltonian graph. Next theorem, Ohr's theorem. If G is a simple graph with n vertices n greater than or equal to 3, such that degree of u plus degree of v greater than or equal to n for every pair of non-adjacent vertices u and v. So this is the statement of Ohr's theorem. Now we apply this statement. We have to show that. So if G is a simple graph with n vertices n greater than or equal to 3, such that degree of u plus degree of v greater than or equal to n. So we have to show that this condition for every pair of non-adjacent vertices u and v. So here u and v are non-adjacent vertices. Okay. So now we consider an example that graph has four vertices A, B, C, D. It satisfies the condition n greater than or equal to 3. So consider the given graph G. We are taking the vertices A and C. So these two are not adjacent vertices. So degree of A and D. So A and D, we consider A and D. These two are not adjacent vertices. So adjacent vertices of A are B and C. So now we consider not adjacent vertices, that is A and D. So degree of A plus degree of D greater than or equal to 4. So the degree of A from the given graph is 2 and the degree of D from the given graph is 2. So 2 plus 2 greater than or equal to 4, that is 4 greater than or equal to 4. Okay. So it satisfies the condition. So the given graph satisfies the Ohr's theorem. So what is the Ohr's theorem statement? If G is a simple graph with n vertices, that condition n greater than or equal to 3, such that degree of u plus degree of v greater than or equal to n. The condition is u and v are not adjacent vertices. Okay. So if we consider any two non-adjacent vertices, vertices are satisfies the condition degree of u plus degree of v greater than or equal to n. Here n is the number of vertices in a given graph. If it satisfies, then we say that the given graph satisfies the Ohr's theorem. Okay. Next, another graph, another example, A, B, C, D, E, F. So it has the vertices, 6 vertices and 7 edges. So consider the given graph G. We are taking the vertices A and D. So in this, we consider two vertices A and D. Now we apply, they are not adjacent vertices. Degree of A is 2 and degree of D is 2. So 2 plus 2, 4 greater than or equal to 6. It condition is not satisfied. So this is false. So the given graph not satisfies the Ohr's theorem. Hence the given graph G does not satisfy the Ohr's theorem. Okay. So next theorem. In any graph G, the total number of odd degree vertices is even. So in any graph G, what is the statement? The total number of odd degree vertices is even. So total degree is equal to, you have to prove total degree is equal to sum of even degree plus sum of odd degree. So total degree, we represent total degree of given vertices of given graph is summation degree of V. Here V is a vertex set that is equal to sum of degree of V, even degree plus sum of odd degree. So by, we know that by handshaking theorem. So what is the statement of handshaking theorem? Summation degree of V is equal to twice the edges of the given graph. So by using handshaking theorem, sum of the total degree is equal to twice its edge set, twice its edge set. So sum of degree of V, that value is equal to, from equation one, degree of even degree, sum of even degree plus sum of odd degree is equal to 2 into E. So from that we write sum of odd degree is equal to 2E minus sum of even degree. So 2E, 2 multiple here. So it is even number minus degree of even degrees. So we get even number. So from this we say that sum of odd degree vertices is even. Sum of odd degree vertices is even. Okay. In a directed graph, so note points, in a directed graph, sum of odd degree vertices is equal to sum of in degree vertices is equal to number of edges in G. So that is summation V belongs to V, sum of odd degree, sum of even degree is equal to number of edges in G. Okay. So every edge is calculated twice, one for in degree and one for out degree. Loop is also calculated twice, one for in degree and one for out degree. The maximum degree of a vertex in a simple graph is n minus 1. If the given graph has n vertices, then the degree of any vertex in that graph is n minus 1. Okay. So next, maximum number of edges in a simple graph with n vertices is n into n minus 1 by 2. So we have to prove maximum number of edges in a simple graph with n vertices is n into n minus 1 by 2. So by handshaking theorem, we have sum of the total degree is equal to 2 into edge set. So sum of the degrees of all vertices means D of V1 plus degree of V1 plus degree of V2 plus and so on plus degree of En is equal to 2 into E. So if maximum number in a simple graph, it has n vertices, then each vertex has degree n minus 1. So here V1 has degree n minus 1, V2 has degree n minus 1, V3 has degree n minus 1 and so on. N minus 1 is equal to 2e. So in how many times it is? N times. So n into n minus 1 is equal to 2e. From that e is equal to n into n minus 1 by 2. So here e is maximum number of edge in a simple graph. Okay. So maximum number of edges in a simple graph with n vertices is n into n minus 1 by 2. Hence, prove the given statement. Okay.